Now I look cool. Yeah, poolies. Let's get going. Next to me, next to you, next to me, baby, next to you, next to me.
Riding down the road in my pickup truck, you better be ready, cause I'm picking you up. With the full moon shining and a little bit of luck, we'll run out of gas and maybe get stuck. We can get lost, baby, I don't care, I ain't worried as long as you're there. Ain't no place that I'd rather be, next to you, sitting next to me. Enough money for my gas and oil. Who needs your shrimp and your caviar? But I'm soon to have you just the way you are. Rich people got the money to hold. Mansion on the hill with diamonds and gold. Can't compare as far as
money though.
Shit. Well, first stop then is CEX. Let's go see what we got. Right then, so that was Ad Astra, and they had loads of copies of Bad Boys and the other one there, which was Birds of Prey. They got Frozen here in 3D, very nice. Jurassic World, the still book, very nice condition, pristine condition in fact. Night Moves, not seen it, quite interested, but I didn't pick it up today. Saw this one, I have seen this movie, it's not my favourite of the Studio Ghiblis, but I do like it. Toy Story 3, got this in a box set, but that is an amazing slipcover, really like that one. And of course, Friday the 13th on DVD, the box set. I've got it on Blu-ray, but it's a nice set and you don't see it too often, so, oh there he is, look, old Jason. Anyway, let's pop down to, through town then. I'm going to pop to Poundland. That's right, the next stop of the day. And so we popped into Poundland. Oh, look, there's me old mate Stu coming up with his breakfast. Yeah. And so we popped into Poundland then, had a little look. And guess what? The same old shit. It just doesn't seem to get any better, does it? No. It just seems to stay where it wants to stay. They need to get a new delivery in, people. I am getting bored. Anyway, that was that. And now we're going to pop over to HMV, his master's voice. That's right, in Pooley, of course. And there's Emma, the DVD. And we went over to the Blu-ray section, had a look there. They had some titles there, but there wasn't really that much out this week. There was Emma on Blu-ray. The wife has seen it, but not very good, apparently. And there's a Blu-ray, which I did pick up. Sorry about the wonky video there. Never mind. Oh, there's The Exorcist. Fantastic. Right then, two pickups. The Exorcist. With an ice look. Dream Demon. Well, we're just heading into Bournemouth now. I'm going to have a look in CEX and HMV and go see my mate John and guess Katie's going to Primark now. But yeah, let's go see what they got.
Right then, into the second sex shop. And Katie did pick this one up, $1 million baby. Yes, baby.
And we had a look round some of the Blu-rays, and there wasn't really that much in this one, so we headed down to the Bournemouth HMV just for a little wander, because, well, why not? It's on the way, isn't it? And I did see Saw, the box set. I have seen this Saw, too expensive. As Wurzel Gummidge, that's not the Wurzel Gummidge I grew up with, I'm afraid not, and it was pretty bad.
Well, in the HMV, I picked up something very cool, which I will show you later on when I get home, and she has as well, so we've done really well. We've just seen some people walking around with McDonald's in their hands, so we're going to go and find out what's going on. We want McDonald's. Just had McDonald's as a rare treat, and my god, it's so good to have it back. A bit of normality, hey missus. Oh, I do love a Big Mac. Never thought I'd ever miss a Big Mac, but I did, and I didn't have to wear a cardboard box this time. Anyway, we're gonna go pop them down to see my mate John. It was his birthday, got him a couple of presents, and I'm gonna go and say hello in the sweet shop. So let's go and say hello to old John boy.
My buddy until the end, more than a buddy, you're my best friend. I love you more than you will ever know. I will never let you go.
Anyway, all done in Bournemouth. I've been to see my mate John. He liked his presents and got some sweeties
for tomorrow's
film day. That's right, we're having a quiet one tomorrow because I've got to go work on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. So, but I am off next week, so expect lots of videos.
And we're celebrating.
It's our anniversary on Tuesday, and that's also the day of the big draw. 500 subscribers giveaway. That's next Tuesday. Get your entries in on that video as soon as you can. I can't believe the response we've had, and it's going really, really well. So let's go on home. We're not going on a summer holiday. We're just staying home because of COVID-19.
Bring her love to me, dream lover, until then.
won't believe what I just found in Poundland. Let's get home and I'll show you. And we're home, people. Hooray! And it's been a fantastic day for pickups. I am over the moon with my pickups today. Oh, I'm really, really pleased. And I'm going to show you why. Because we went to Poonie, and went to Bournemouth, and we went to Winton. We popped in to see my friend John, who was very well and happy to be back at work. And he loved his presence. And it was good to see him again. We've missed him, and he's such a great mate. He really is. So anyway, we saw him, and then we came back home, and we had McDonald's people out, not in a drive. I didn't have me bloody box. So I actually went and bought it normally. It was a bit odd though how they got this system inside. You had to go left, then right, and then left, and then right. And then I end up just, the woman said, you don't have to do that, you just stand there. Thank you for letting me do the whole shebang. Anyway, let's get on to what I call a segment I like to call... That's right, the shit we bought. So I'm going to go over what I bought, and then I'm going to include what Katie bought, because... Well, she bought some shit as well, and she wants to show you what she got. So, why not indeed? So, what did I get today? Well, the first shop we went into was HMV Poodie. And this was the one for me today that I was really pleased to pick up. And that is Dream Demon. With the gorgeous slip and the embossing. Well, not embossing, what they call it. Oh, you know, what do they call it? It's gone right now. But this is just... Oh... I tell you, I was so pleased to see it there. They only had one copy in Bournemouth and one copy in Poole. Well, I picked this at the Poole branch. And the Bournemouth one at the top here had a really bad dent on the top part of the slip cover. So I was glad to have got it in Poole, to be honest with you. And like I said, I actually started watching this on YouTube. It's never been released on DVD. It was only released on VHS for rental. And I started watching it on YouTube just to see what it's like, and the picture quality was... awful. And so I thought, I want to watch this properly, so I thought, let's get the proper copy if I can get my hands on it. And I nabbed the only copy. I was so pleased to pick this up. And it's quite an odd film, but it's a really good British horror movie.
Now I have the pleasure.
Leave me alone, Diana. There's this little girl here. I don't know if she's real or not. I don't know if she's dead or not.
And if you're a film collector of horror, you've got to get it. Sorry, it's just one of them. So there we go. There's the first pickup. Absolutely over the moon. And do you know, on to the next one. I never owned this before. Not really, no. I've never had the video, DVD, or Blu-ray. It's because when I first watched it, it scared the living shit out of me, because I was... So I was watching it with Mum, and then all sorts of weird shit happened afterwards when I watched it. Bad things happening, and it put me off. Because it is a cursed film, you know, apparently. But I had to pick it up. The Exorcist, because I've got The Exorcist 3.
The special edition by Arrow, which is really nice.
And I've got now Exorcist 1, and I've got Exorcist 2 on the way. So I'm really pleased to pick this up, because it's got a nice slip on it. I do like this artwork. It has the normal artwork inside, which is better, but I like this as an alternative. I like things that stand out that are different, and that stands out for me. So there we go, The Exorcist, and that was $7.99 with a nice slip. Pick that one up. Then we went into Bournemouth, and I popped into HMV there, and I realised that I had something to be collected.
My steelbook for Parasite finally came in, and you see that? $19.99! Not $24.99, which is what it went through as. And I said to the lady about it when I was picking it up, so I pre-ordered it when it was $19.99, and it says it on the sticker. So I'm going to charge you $19.99, because that's what you paid when you pre-ordered it. That's what you... Okay, you know what I mean. So there we go. Very happy to have Parasite. It is a fantastic film. And the standard Blu-ray is nice, but the title is all wrong. It's the wrong way around. And there's just something about this artwork. It's just fantastic. Right, you see that, right? If you turn it upside down, you can see it's quite shiny. If I do that, right, that's a bit better. So you see them going upstairs, turn it upside down, and look, Parasite, and they're all going up the stairs again. Fantastic. So video, please. It is a lovely steelbook. Absolutely love it. So glad to have that in the collection. And yes, it's a good film. Not for everybody, but it's a very good film. I actually saw it back in November on the plane to Florida. That was a very awkward situation because I was between my wife, who doesn't give a monkey's what I watch, and this girl who must have been about 20, and I was in the middle, and I was watching this film, and there's a very naughty scene in the middle, which I won't go into spoilers, but you can imagine that it's quite a naughty scene.
Oh, matron, take them away!
And it was a bit awkward. Right then, so, enough bollocks, let's carry on, and we're going to go into the things I picked up from Poundland. And as you saw a minute ago, I said, you never believe what I got from Poundland. Well, you won't believe what I got from Poundland. I was shocked. Shocked. They must have missed it. I'm not going to give it away. But the first thing I picked up then was Flight of the Living Dead. I haven't seen this one, and I do love these movies. It's not George A. Romero. You think it would be, because that's Night of the Living Dead. But this is Flight of the Living Dead. And I don't think I've seen this one. I think that's going to... No, but close enough, I guess. I'll do that. There you go. anyway. So, yeah, I'm going to give it a go. It's only a quid. If it's shit, off it goes. So that was that one. I also picked up this one. I saw it in one of the previous vlogs, but I decided to pick it up because I was interested in this one. Never seen it. It's called The Goatman Murders. Devil Riders, maybe alright. And The Maze, I have seen The Maze, and it is a big load of donkey shit. But I would give it another go. Just, you know, as I've got the three, I might watch the three in one go, see how I do. Do a review, maybe. I don't think people are really asking for a review for these, but I might add it. I'll obviously add it into my monthly What Did I Watch series, which is, I'll be coming next week. So, yeah. This won't be in that go. I don't think I've got time between now and the end of the month to watch it because I've got work, sadly. But yeah, I'll be checking those out. I really want to see that one. Intrigued about that one. I might give that another go as I've got it again. So now, the next one I got from Poundland. Penny Dreadful, Complete Season 1. Now, then, when this first came out, this was about 20 quid. 20 quid. And I saw it as brand spanking new. And I thought, why not? Why not? Three disc set, and it's not Blu-ray, but contains gory violence, very strong language, and strong sex. So it got me so. Anyway, so yeah, I think it's like a vampire thing, but I think my friend Sophie, she loves this. So if you haven't got it, Sophie, and I don't like it, you can have it. But I'm pretty sure you've got it. But for £1, it's worth a go, isn't it? Another one I picked up from Poundland is The Forgotten, which I forgot about this. It's probably a load of wank, but it might be all right. That's my critical professionalism there. It looks like some sort of like hospital drama, ghost story sort of thing. I don't think it's a camera job, but I will give it a go. I'll give it a go, see what it's like. And for £1, I'm very happy to pick it up. Now, we're getting to the thing that I could not believe was in Poundland. You ready for it? Gone with the Wind. Gone with the Wind. Just that. I can't believe it. It was in Poundland. Gone with the Wind. it's been banned. I mean, we went to HMV and they took them all the copies off the shelf. Went into Poundland. There it was, right at the very back of a stack. They must have missed it. And it was the other way around like that. So they must have not realised. I tell you. So the wife's just coming over. She's got a bit to film in a sec. My mate bought the Blu-ray of this. I mean, to be honest, I'm not really interested in seeing it. I really am not. I'm not even bothered about owning it. But I got it because it's been taken off the shelf. And it's not allowed to be sold. I think it will come round again, though. I really do think it will. But for the moment in time, you can't buy it. And I saw it in there for £1. I've got to have it because I am a lover of film, cinema. You know, I love movies. And even though this is not my cup of tea, it is 3 hours and 45 minutes long. It's not a film that I'm going to be rushing to watch, but I may watch it one day or try to watch it one day just to see how it is, because I've never seen it. It's just never tickled my fancy. But I would give it a go, and for £1,
it's worth it. Especially now. I mean, I might even get a fiver for it on eBay or whatever. So if I don't like it, people will want it because it is no longer available. So, well, for the time being anyway. So I think that will get rectified. I think it will turn around and come back.
Like Little Britain.
Yeah, Little Britain. I do believe it'll all come out, or it'll come back and everything, you know, things will calm down a bit. And if not, then, well, we've got our DVDs, haven't we? So there we go then. That was my pickups for today. I'm very happy with my pickups. Ooh! Hang on. Ooh! That's a fucking shelf right there. Anyway, let's go and see what the wife bought today.
So, we went to CEX in Bournemouth and in Poole. And I got Open Season. £1. I've never seen it, but apparently it's quite good. I had a voucher as well, so please didn't cost me anything theoretically. I got A Life Less Ordinary. Looked good. For a love story from the makers of Transporter. Trainspotting, rather. No.
Yeah, you're right. Danny Boyle.
Yeah, him.
So Trainspotting.
And then I got Laws of Attraction. Again, I haven't seen it, but it sounded quite good. And for 50p, you can't go wrong, really.
No.
Then we popped into CEX in Bournemouth to pick this one up. We saw it in Poundland a few months ago, just before lockdown. And then we didn't pick it up for some reason.
Yeah, we missed it, didn't we?
Because we missed it until we got home and watched the video back. And then we haven't been able to find it since. So I looked on CEX and they had one copy in Bournemouth. £1.50.
Rock and roll.
So say 50p. Then we went into Poundland in Winton. And got this Circle of Life. Sounded good. For a quid. Can't go wrong. And then I got Turner and Hooch.
It's all Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks. Gotta love Tom Hanks. So that's the films I brought. And then obviously Pope Catholic. We went to Primark. Went to the one in Poole and went to the one in Bournemouth. The Poole one, I took some stuff back. So I got some more stuff. And I'll show you what I've got. Here's some Winnie the Pooh bottoms. You know how much I love Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, yes.
And got the top to go with it. I can get it out. That one. And then they've relaunched the Toy Story pyjamas. And I got the bottoms last year, but they have a different top to go for, actually match the pyjamas this year. So I got the top to go with it. And then we went Primark. I got two lovely t-shirts. Got this nice Toy Story one. What do you think?
Yeah, I like that. It's really cool. It's Toy Story, so it's cool.
And then I got this Disney Pixar one.
Yeah, it's like nice that. That.
And the back is like that.
Oh, really, so nice. I'm going to scan on down, so... My eyes up at the bottom. Fantastic.
It's really nice. And then got this Toy Story 4 money box, money bank. It's got all the, like, I'll open it up so you can actually see it properly. It's all the, like, characters, like Buzz, Woody, and Bo Peep driving up.
Mhm.
And you got him on the side.
You can't really see it. That's it.
Like that.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it?
Got the aliens on the back.
Ooh.
And then you got Jesse and Hulk, Hank.
The claw. Yeah.
And then I got some sun cream.
Exciting bit at the end.
Because it was like...
That's the twist.
30 degrees.
Yeah, it's really hot today.
It probably isn't today, but I feel that.
Mm. Is that it then?
And I've got some scones, but that's not that exciting.
They're in the kitchen.
No, they're not. They're here.
All right, they're here. Anyway, thanks, Kate, for showing us what you got.
You're welcome, darling.
And that is it. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoy this sort of mini shopping vlog to Bournemouth and Pooley. More videos coming soon. Like I said earlier in the video, I am working on Friday, Saturday and Sunday, but then I am off for a week, so expect some videos that week. Well, definitely, in fact. And don't forget, like I said earlier, go and make sure you go into my 500 giveaway subscriber thing, because there's some prizes to be drawn next Tuesday, the 30th of June. Now, that is me and the wife's wedding anniversary as well. So we'll be doing a wedding day. No, we're not doing a wedding again. We'll be doing an anniversary video, a vlog, if you will. We'll be going back down to Bournemouth and we're going to do some shopping.
We're going to get Chinese for dinner.
And we'll just see what we get up to. So that would be my Tuesday vlog, but also be slash... because obviously I work every Tuesday, so I don't get the opportunity to film a Tuesday video for a Tuesday vlog. So that'd be a perfect day to do it, and on our anniversary, so it'd be even special. And of course, we've got the big draw that day, and we'll be doing that in the evening, not at midday, because, well, mainly because we're going to be going out, but also I want you guys to have as much opportunity to get in there as possible. So, yeah. There we go. So hopefully, you know, you guys will win something and you can still enter up until around about 4 o'clock, because I'm going to write it all down and put it in a bit of paper, put it in a hat, and we're going to do a video. Wish we could do a live video, but sadly, I don't have enough subscribers to do that. Currently at 590. Hello to all my new subscribers. Thank you for joining up with us, me, and really do appreciate it. I'm overwhelmed, and there's so many videos coming, and I'm always willing to do whatever videos you would like with amazing people. So if there's any sort of thing you'd like me to, like a film review, there's a film you want me to review, or somewhere you want me to go, or if there's, you know, let me know and I'll do what I can. So that's it. I've talked too much for now, so I'm going to go. But I will see you again soon, probably at the weekend and into next week, of course. So take care. Please like, share and subscribe. Stay safe, and all the best to me and the wife, of course, as well. Bye for now.
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.